For today's video, I wanted to share one of the Close to My Heart Workshop on the Go kits. I did one of these last year for the 12 days, and I'm going to be giving one of these away, as well as showing you some really fun projects and just showing you kind of the great value that you get in one of these kits. There are many available at aboverubies.ctmh.com. as well as other Close to My Heart consultants. You get some really cool gold sequin pieces. And the cool thing about these is that they already have adhesive on them. And you also get this really awesome Yuletide assortment kit, which comes with some really great glitter pieces. I'm gonna open this up though and show it to you. And with every Workshop on the Go kit, sometimes you get ribbon, you get bonus accessories, you get just all kinds of really cool things that coordinate and go along. Look at this beautiful rose. Isn't that awesome? And then these are some wood pieces, Mary Peace, the 25 for Christmas. And these are little just gold medallions, and they all have adhesive already on them. So they're awesome. Each Workshop on the Go kit, whether it's a card making or a scrapbooking, comes with an exclusive stamp set that you can only get within this as well. And my favorite are these little tickets down here. It actually coordinates with the art booking Cricut cartridge. There's a really big piece on earth, and then there's the ticket that you can cut out, the circle, and then the tag. So it's great that you don't have to hand cut out your stamps. That's what I love about Close to My Heart. And then you get really awesome assortments of paper and directions to create beautiful scrapbook layouts, and literally step-by-step instructions how to recreate exactly what you see here in a beautiful, beautiful way, to the point of they show you, if you watch last year's video, I actually took the time to cut out each individual thing exactly how it shows. Now, I like to be creative on my own, and it allows you to do all those different things. But the great thing about this is it's a wonderful value. It actually helps you save money, which is what we all want to do when we want to preserve our memories. We don't want to, you know, we want to get new fun things to fill our craft room with without spending an arm and a leg every time. But look at these beautiful papers, and they transcend beyond Christmas. Like this rose, like they're very unique in my opinion. They are Christmassy, but there's just so much that you can do with them and utilizing different colors. So what I want to do today is create, oh, by the way, it does come with your solid cardstock as well. So you're not just getting the designer pattern papers, you're getting the solid cardstocks that coordinate along with it. And they work beautifully for cards, layouts, and then we're actually later in this 12 days going to be doing a really neat wreath with this paper as well. So what I'm gonna do is, let's take a look at what inspiration they have here. This is really beautiful. This is the layout, and then there's an alternative layout. Oh my goodness, that one's simply beautifully stunning. And we could recreate this very reasonably here, very quickly. So we're gonna actually go very close to an idea here, but I'm gonna make it my own a little bit, okay? So this is one of the Close to My Heart. We're gonna make it our own. So I'm gonna set this here for my inspiration. I'm gonna select my papers that I wanna use. I'm going to actually do that black base. And I know black and Christmas and you're going, what? But I just love the way it looks up here. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna give it a try. We're gonna see how this comes out for us. I think it's gonna be stunning. So we have that. I want to structure this. I need this as well. I'm gonna structure this for two different photos, I think, and do my photo mattings for it. So we're gonna actually start by getting some type of photo matting started. And I'm actually going to do a, let's say we're doing 2 4x6 photos. So let's make this 8 inches. Nope, I lied. Let's do 8.5 inches. So this is going to be 8.5 inches by 12. And you know what? Let's just make it for 1 4x6, and then we could do 2 smaller ones. So let's take this down to 7 inches. I have my champagne at 7 inches. I'm going to take the border off of here. This is the rose border. That is the reverse side of the, I love this. This is just awesome. We're gonna take this. Reverse side of the label. And you can use that rose border. I want to take, of course that's on the same side. Oh well. We're going to go to 8 inches on this guy. All the way down to the 8 inches. And then you have the reverse here to work with as well. You could use that on a beautiful card front. I mean, that would be stunning on a card for Christmas. All right, so that's gonna go in the center of our page. That borders out nicely. We wanna cut this down now. I want this to be done at 8.5 inches. And now I'm gonna take our green, which is, I do believe, if I'm not mistaken, New England Ivy. And if we're doing a 4x6 photo, I'm just going to do 4.25 by 6.5. Four and a quarter, 6.5. And then let's plan this for like a 4x4 square card. So we'll just make it 4.25 by 4.25, or whatever we want to do with it. Okay, for another picture if we want it. Have it there ready to go just in case. All right. Oh my goodness, this is just beautiful paper. Straighten that out. Now I'm gonna do some pleating with this along the front, right here. And I'm actually just gonna start adhering some of this down, but when I do adhering, well, you know what? I take that back. I don't know what I'm gonna do. Okay, so let's mark this where this is. This is in the center, as much of the center as we can go. I'm gonna use a pencil. I'm gonna mark here and here. And then I can easily erase. I'm gonna grab the stamp set that's included. You should pretty much be able to see where they're at easily. And I'm going to take some of the stamps included. I'm gonna grab VersaMark watermark stamp pad, and I'm gonna do some gold heat embossing. I think this will be beautiful. Down here. Get some of that in. This is available at Close to My Heart. It's the gold powder from Close to My Heart, but it's actually a Ranger Princess Gold, so you don't just have to get it from Close to My Heart, but if you don't have any, you can pick it up when you pick up your kit as well. I have a big old crafty splat mat. So you just pour the gold powder on. Get it moved all over and on in. Ugh, isn't that gorgeous? Pow, that is gold. Okay. Let's grab our Permatac adhesive. Kind of kind of line back up where we had . All right, so we got that all going on there. I'm going to just do a couple strips of my glue on my champagne, adhesive on my champagne. Right on down. And this is for the exact size of the photo it's a quarter inch bigger than the size of the photo I want to use. And I'm just going to do a little bit in the center, because that way I can tuck things in and behind and do different fun with that as we go. Okay, so then I'm going to use these images here, right up the side, and I'm going to do it in the green New England Ivy, which coordinates the two colors. I'm going to do them pretty close together. Try to kind of line them up right on here. You could do this in gold and heat emboss these as well, but I think this will be pretty good. Oh, I love it. I love this. I love this. I don't know, I'm getting excited now. I'm excited, sorry. Now what I'm going to do is take this as a border along the bottom, and I'm going to go all the way off the page with it. Right meeting the edge of the green, which is, again, New England Ivy, and you can just rip it and then tuck it.
With the adhesive right on the end, get a good straight
crisp line, pretty easy. I'm going to take another piece of the champagne, and I'm going to do Peace on Earth, and I'm going to hand cut that out. And again, I'm going to do this in the New England Ivy, and then I might add a little bit more color to it as we go, but we'll see. We'll see how that kind of plays out for us. Because go figure, this one doesn't have a cricket shape to cut out, but that's all right. Tonic shears, and I'm actually going to cut it out sort of along the lines of how it was cut out for this layout example. That's really cool. All right, that can go down here, and that's going to be popped up, kind of overlapping a little bit of everything. I'm going to take this strip right along the bottom here. You can see there's some gold, and then there's gold writing, and then the fun. I'm going to just take that whole strip. It's about 2 inches wide. It is 2 inches wide. 2 inches wide right here. And what we're going to do is start by adhesive right here down the side. And then I'm going to hand fold, because it is double-sided paper, so whatever comes through on the other side will just be beautiful. And then you need to use some adhesive as you go, but make sure you're not covering where your photo needs to be tucked in, okay? Word of warning there. All right, so you're gonna do some adhesive on the fold and then on the next portion as you go. And this doesn't need to go all the way across. As a matter of fact, it won't reach all the way across. You'd have to piece it together. That'll be good, because I still have this. So then what I'm going to do is just cut a triangle into the center point. If you need a little more adhesive on the inside, just go ahead and stick that on down. And along the bottom here, there's some green notes and this red with the stocking. I'm just gonna cut out that like green portion. Looks like a little bit of tape. It's on the same piece of paper, and I'm going to just stick that down in here. And again, I'm gonna do a little triangle in it just to give some variation in sizes. Perfect. Okay, so we got that part. Now this is gonna go right up on here. I'm going to use the You Cut It foam. Just a piece of that. Again, it's in the embellishment combo pack by Megan Elizabeth. It is available. This is the last year, Christmas time, it's going to be available. Actually, let's cut this in half and do two pieces. Tonic shears work great for this because they do resist some of that adhesive. They clean off really easily. So again, there's no adhesive on this green portion. It's just sticking up. All right, I want to grab, I'm really using this guy as my inspiration for recreating this. I'm just doing different colors. And there's not step-by-step instructions on that one, so it's just really your own point on this. Oh my goodness, that rose is just beautiful. It is really beautiful. Like, you can't tell, like, the resin work on it is just, it's so nice. Like, it's beautiful. Nice. And I'm going to take three of the dots. I'm actually going to use these guys up right here. Line them up. Right there. Like so. Now I'm going to do this guy coming down here. I'm going to do two strips. They're a little varying in width. Oh, that's actually kind of cool. How would that look? I don't like how that looks. I'm going to do it this way. All right. Again, the pennant cut in. That one's going to come down there, but then I'm going to do another green one. I'm going to shorten him up. And maybe before I put this one down, I'm going to stamp on him. Let's see. What stamps are in here that I could use? I'm just going to do tone on tone. So I'm going to grab the one little sprig, and I'm going to use the New England Ivy again. And just going to stamp right on there. All right, now let's adhere these down. This one's gonna go on the bottom. So we'll start with this one. There we go. And the adhesive is on there. We're just gonna go right at the top of the page with that. And then I'm gonna show you, I love these. Sequins are super hot and popular right now, and to already have the adhesive on them makes life so easy, because sequins can make a hot mess really quick, as much as glitter can, to be honest with you. Yeah, they really can, but they're awesome. We'll do a big one, and then a little smaller one right there. And then we're gonna do a little more sequins down here. Because that would actually be beautiful coming down here, which I didn't really think about.
Can that tuck under there and then fit in here?
It does! That was like totally accidental. I love when that kind of stuff happens, but doesn't that look pretty? Kind of offset some of that? All right, that's what we're gonna do. So one strip of adhesive in there, and I said about using it on a card, but why not on the layout? Now I am going to take the 25 and I'm going to put it right here. There we go. Awesome. All right, well, that should about do it for our scrapbook layout for today. Lots more coming through the 12 days, giveaways, and a lot of other fun. Really just came together pretty quickly and nicely. So enjoy the moments, have an awesome day, and I'll see you again at AboveRubyStudio.com.